Well, is it possible to use narrowband filters on a DSLR? In this video, I will show you what I discovered. I recently bought this H-alpha filter from SV Bonnie. This is a 7nm 2-inch hydrogen alpha filter. That means it only allows H-alpha wavelengths narrowly. The space is full of hydrogen alpha, and this filter makes sure that you can capture it. One of the many benefits of this kind of filters is that you can take photos even when the moon is staring down in the sky. So it doesn't matter if the moon is up or you've got extraordinary light pollution, this filter will skip all that and give you a pure H-alpha wavelength photos on any target. Well, these filters are usually designed for dedicated astrophotography mono cameras, so it will be interesting to see if DSLR will work with it at all. Before I show you the results, let me tell you that I'll be using this with an unmodified Canon 1100D camera. This test is done with SV Bonnie 102mm refractor with flattener attached. I use auto guiding as well for this test. All the exposures are 300 seconds guided exposures. So let me begin by showing you one single 300 second frame. I used ISO 1600, and this is how your image will look straight out of your camera. The sea of red it is. Let me extract hydrogen alpha only to show you how much HA has been captured. I have just performed a little stretch on this photo, so no excessive editing. And you can see there is some hydrogen alpha captured even with an unmodified DSLR. The structure around the Horsehead Nebula is there too, and this will become more visible with stacked version. Let me show you the stacked version now. Again, I have just stretched the photo, nothing else. The amount of detail in this photo is simply amazing. This is just 3 hours exposure in total, with 300 seconds exposure each. I'm quite impressed with this, to be honest with you. I didn't think that an unmodified camera could make out such hydrogen alpha details. You can easily use this data and combine it with the normal data to create a fantastic photo. Well, I plan to use this filter every time the moon is out to continue collecting data and not waste any night. That's it. Of course, you would get much better and less noisy results if you were to use with a proper Astro camera, but I think for all of us who are on the budget, this can be a good setup to continue doing astro even when the moon is out. So can you use narrowband filters with an unmodified camera? Heck yes. If you found this video to be helpful, please subscribe for more.